Thou seest, we are not all alone and happy. This wide and universal theater presents more woeful pageants than the scene wherein we play it.
All the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts. His acts mean seven ages. At first, the infant, mewling and puking in his nurse's arms. Then the whining schoolboy, with a satchel and shining morning face, creeping like snail, unwilling to school. And then the lover, sighing like furnace, with a woeful ballad made to his mistress's eyebrow. Then a soldier, full of strange oaths and bearded like the pard, jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel, seeking the bubble reputation even in the cannon's mouth. And then the justice, in fair round belly with good cape and lined, with eyes severe and beard a formal cut, full of wise saws and modern instances. And so he plays his part. The sixth age shifts into the lean and slippered pantaloon, with spectacles on nose and pouch on side, his youthful hose well saved, a world too wide, for his shrunk shrank, and his big manly voice, turning again towards childish treble, pipes and whistles in his sound. Last scene of all, that ends this strange, eventful history, is second childishness and mere oblivion. Sans teeth, sans eyes, sans taste, sans everything.